electromechanical breakdown. So in the electromechanical breakdown, so we'll talk about how electromechanical breakdown occurs. What it mean by electromechanical breakdown? So here what happened, we are talking about the solid dielectric. So solid dielectric happen, it will having the whenever it will affect it. So when solid dielectrics are subject to the high electrical field, okay, so we'll talk about the if it is having in between the high electrical field, if it is supposed to be subjected to the high electrical field, and failures occur due to the electrostatic compressive forces. Okay, so here we having, so if we talk about here one is we having the one solid material will be there. Okay, so what we are going, so we are going to provide the one electrostatic. Okay, so we are providing the electrostatic compressive force. What will happen due to the high external force? Okay, due to the high forces, what will happen? So some of the force, okay, some due to the force in this around, so it will goes to the leading, the electrons will be flows will be there. Okay, so what will happen due to that, the voltage, okay, due to the high voltage, what will happen, it goes to the breakdown. Okay, it will goes to the breakdown in the, it will cause the some of the cracks will be there. Okay, so that will cause us to the breakdown in the solid. So now coming to this, so electromechanical breakdown. So whenever the solid dielectrics are subject to the high electrical field, so failure occurs due to the electrostatic compressive forces can exceed the mechanical compressive strength. So what we are doing, so here we state that, so due to the high electrical fields, okay, whenever the applied in the solid dielectrics subject to the in the high electrical field and fails, so it will be causes the failure due to the electrostatic compressive force, okay, so which are the exceeds the, so whatever the mechanical compressive strength is. So if it is a solid dielectric strength having the some mechanical strength will be there, or as well as in the electrical strength. So if exceeds the mechanical strength, okay, whatever the mechanical strength is there, so if we exceed the electrical forces beyond the mechanical compressive force, so it will cause us the some failure to be. So due to this, this breakdown will occur. Okay, so here we are talk about, so if the thickness, so if we are considering that, if the thickness of the specimen, so we are considering, so we are considering that is d naught and compressed to thickness d under the applied voltage. So here we are considering the equation, so how it is be breakdown is occurring. So it will be again we will explain in the next class, okay, because in this class we are going to cover only the what, okay, what is what, okay, what we having, so how it is a breakdown circuit and how it is a breakdown circuit, what are the breakdown. Okay, so we will explain detail in the board in this equation, because every equation if you understand the written per written, okay, then you can understand easily, right? So we'll explain this one is again. So that first we have to know that what is the electromechanical break. So here what we did, so if you have if the solid dielectric subject to the high electrical field, it will causes the breakdown. So and it will cause the failure. So due to that is whatever the mechanical compressive force is there, strength is there, if it exceeds the electrical fields, okay, whatever the electro force is there, electrostatic force is there, if it exceeds the mechanical strength, then it will causes the failure chance. Okay, that will causes the failure. That is that will cause the, that is electromechanical breakdown. So now we'll talk about the so thermal breakdown. Okay, how it's a thermal breakdown. So here what is by mean by thermal breakdown refer to. So in the here the breakdown voltage, okay, here in general the breakdown voltage of solid dielectric should increase its thickness. So it is common. So whatever the thickness, if we consider the strength, okay, so the thickness of the dielectrics, so it will be increases with the thickness of the solid. So whatever the, if it consider the paper, okay, if you consider the paper dielectric strength, so if you come if the dielectric strength will be increased with bundle of the paper, Okay, for single paper or double paper, so whatever the impregnate paper if considering, so if it is a whatever the thickness, so thickness if increases, the breakdown strength also if it, okay. But when not truly, so but is that truly up to this certain thickness above, okay, it will with the heat generator, okay. So a thickness above which the heat is generated in the dielectrical due to the flow of determine the condition, okay. So what considering here, what we can see, so if it is solid dielectric, should have the increase its thickness, okay. So breakdown voltage with solid dielectric should increase the with its thickness, but so the certain thickness, okay, we are going to here, so the condition that at certain thickness above the which the heat generate, okay, here we can see that heat is generated, so whenever the voltage flows as well current will be flowing, so at that condition what will happen, so here due to the heat generated, right. So due to the heat generated in the dielectrical, okay, it will be generated cause the heat. So why heat is generated? That is due to the flow of current determining the conduction, okay. Due to small conduction of current in the dielectrical, it will cause the heat production, okay. So if the electrical field applied, okay, so this is the cause of the heat, okay. How it is the first, how it is the heat is developed, so how it is that, so if that heat causes the breakdown. So how it is the breakdown causes, okay, that heat causes the breakdown in the solid, so how it will be there, okay, that will talk about. So heat here we talk about when an electrical field is applied to the dielectrical, okay, so we are applying the dielectrical material, we are applying the, so that will win a electrical field, okay, and conduction current, okay, so whatever the conduction, that is the here is small, it may be the flows through the metal. So whenever if you consider, so here if you consider here in the transmission and distribution, so we are talk about the pin insulator, okay. So if it is pin insulator, that so if it is a conductor system, so what will happen, due to the small amount of current will be flows through the this solid dielectric, okay, whatever the cross arms there, so cross arms will there, here small amount of leakage current will be flow. So this leakage, to avoid the leakage current, what we are going to, so we are grounding the one wire, right. So one grounded wire will be conducted at the edge pole of the poles, right. So here how is it, so here dielectrical current, so we applied the L1 dielectrical, so like this, and conduction current however the small, so small leakage current will be flown, so it may be a flows through the material, okay. So similarly some small amount of current will flow because some of the impurities in the solid dielectrics and the current heater, okay. So we can see that the current heaters of the specimen and the temperature, so here what happened, so if the specimen temperature, okay, so it will be the current, okay, heats up to the specimen and temperature rise, and heat is generated transferred to the surrounding medium by conduction through the solid dielectrical by radiation from its outer surface, okay. So here if okay is general, so let's talk about this one in the in general, okay. So in general if you talk about, here we having the one pin insulator and we placed it in a distribution line, okay. So if you are having the distribution tower, right, and you have the cross arm, one wire is there, okay, ACSR conductor, that will having the pin insulator, okay. So it will current will flowing due to the current flow, so it will be small leakage current will flow through this one, okay. So what happen whenever the heat is there, okay, surrounding temperature, if you consider the, there having the summer season, so due to the summer season what happened, the high, so surrounding, so we having the, in India we having the higher temperature about to the 45 degrees centigrades, right. So due to that what happened, so it will be cause the high amount of heat will be generated, so due to the heat as well as so surrounding heat and due to the current flow in the conductor, okay, so due to the current flow in the conductor and small leakage current will also flow through this one, okay. So if exceeds the heat, okay, so if exceeds the heat, so what will happen, some breakdown, okay, so it will causes the breakdown, so due to the heat, okay, due to the current flow, that will take place a small amount of current flow, and as well as due to the surrounding area temperature, okay, due to the surrounding area, so here we talk about the radiation, so here we are considering the outer surface some of the radiation due to the radiation of that sun. So what painful causes the small cracks will be there. So it will appear to the sun due to the sun radiation. While pain it will be loses their breakdown strength very small. Okay. So if it continuously the temperature is continuously increases, what will happen? It will cause us to the breakdown. Okay. It will cause the current flow in this line. Okay. So at this time, what will happen? It will be explode. Okay. This is the thermal breakdown. So due to the heat, the solid dielectrical if it fails to the their property, that's called as the thermal breakdown. Okay, so it will be mainly occurred due to the high electrical forces as well as atmosphere conditions. Okay, main thing. Before that, so we have to know that. So how much temperature is there? Okay, at what temperature it can withstand? How much current leakage current that we have to calculate? Okay, before we applying the any dielectrical material in practically.